أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. ليس لنا رب سواه، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء، ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we all preparing for the month of Ramadan. Many of us start put their vacations, arrange their time in the month of Ramadan, what they will do in the month of Ramadan. And this is not our goal in these days, because we are in the month of Sha'ban. And the month of Sha'ban is very important for all the believers. Before we go ahead for the month of Ramadan, it's a preparation of the month, because Ramadan, it's the new year for us. It's the new time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala start counting your deeds for the whole year. But in the month of Sha'ban, the book will be closed for the whole month and raised to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Usama ibn Zayd, he was asking Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, why I see you fasting the most days of Sha'ban? And he said to him, because this is the month يغفل عنه الناس. The people, they don't know about this month. This month is very important. فيه يرفع الأعمال إلى الله. In this month, all the actions, all the deeds will be reached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Will be front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأحب أن ترفع أعمالي إلى الله وأنا صائم. And I hope that all my deeds, all my action for the whole year reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while I'm fasting. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is the month Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count it for you from last Ramadan until the end of Sha'ban, what you did, and this will raise to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you still have time before the end of the year when your deeds reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first thing we have to think about our heart. Our heart, our intention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? What we did the whole year is acceptable or not? And how we make it acceptable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? By our action, by our dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran, He says, subhanahu, لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at your heart. How is your heart? How is your intention? How is your deed? You do it sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or show off. And he can forgive subhanahu wa ta'ala for who he wants. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking for your heart because you are the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is your action? How is your deed? Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said it again to us. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَالْتَنْظُرُ نَفْسُ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have to see what's coming for you, what's waiting for you. We're looking for the Jannah. We need to be among Ashab al-Maymana. We need to be in Jannat al-Na'im. So that's what we have to look for. وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسْهُمْ. Don't be among the people who forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah will let them forget themselves. Don't be among the people, they're waiting for the month of Ramadan. They say, this is the month of Ibadah, month of the Ghufran, month of the Quran. I will be good in this month, I will make dua as much as you can. What about the last year? How is your deeds reached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. Cannot be equal. The people of the hellfire وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ and the people of the Jannah. The success, the people who reach the door of the Jannah and enter it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the people of أهل النار وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْهِمْ نَارٌ مُؤْصَدَةٌ. They are under the fire. When you try to get a flame or you make some wood to get high fires, you put under it. So that's how the people of the hellfire wal'iyadhu billah will be under it. So the nar will come from them. Wal'iyadhu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us in the Holy Quran. That's a book I give it to you, the Quran. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِّنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. If we reveal this book, the Quran, on the mountain, we'll be down and come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What about you, my dear brothers and sisters? How is your heart? Compare your heart by the mountain. The mountain would be scared when you see the Quran and he coming closer to Allah. They make dua to Allah. They talk to Allah. They praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah give us the heart and the brain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's talking to us in Surah Al-Balad. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ. Did we make eyes for you? You can see what we are doing, what Allah gave you, what's around you. And how many people you see it in your way, they are blind, they cannot see. How is the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He gave it to you, He's asking you. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ. Do you have no eyes? You can see what's around you. You can see who is poor, who's in need, who is sick to visit, who needs your help. You don't see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you from the health. You don't see by these eyes how many people sick in the hospital. They cannot even come to the prayer time. You don't see by your eyes. Your parents, the one who work very hard to let you grow up like that. You don't see the ni'am of Allah when He gives you the job. Do you see the ni'am of Allah by your eyes when you go to your own bank to see how you put and how you draw? This is the eyes Allah gave it to you. To enjoy your life, to enjoy your kids, enjoy your wife. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's asking us, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ. And we give you a tongue for dhikrullah azza wa jal, and lips. And without these lips, you cannot even talk. You don't remember who gave you that except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some people cannot even talk. But Allah gave you this ni'mah to make zikr to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remember in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have faith and iman and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will remember in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, أَيَحْسَبُ أَنْ لَنْ يَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ أَحَدٍ. Do you think no one can get you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has the power. He has the power. For the people think you are something important, you will leave everything and go. But if you have an iman, And you get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single karb, kalimati, He will make it easy for you. Look at Sayyidina Ayyub. When he gets sick, what did he say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Oh Allah, I'm getting sick. He didn't blame at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the one who make him sick, Allah. But he never blamed at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, oh Allah, I just get sick. And you are the mercy and kind. That's it. He left it for him subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows Allah is the creator. Sayyidina Yunus alayhi salam, while he's inside the ocean, what did he say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Look, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. He make a tawheed and aqeedah by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا أنت. I believe there's no one except you, Allah. We obey. And then he make tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك. And then he admit that he did the mistake. إني كنت من الظالمين. This is how is the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we do understand the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very important, then we can correct ourselves before the end of this year. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warning us, and he gave us the whole stories, who's will be in the Jannah, who's been in the hellfire, who's following the deen of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again in Surah Ali Imran, he says subhanahu wa ta'ala, قُلْ إِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا وَمَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ سُوءٍ تَوَدُّ لَوْ أَنَّ بَيْنَهَا وَبَيْنَهُ أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ وَاللَّهُ رَؤُوفٌ بِالْعِبَادِ. Allah knows what's inside you, what you hide inside you when you talk to your brother by the face and your heart is different. When you come closer to Allah because you need something after He gave it to you, you ignore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wal'a'adhu billah. He knows what's there. And He said to us, whatever you're doing good, it will be in front of you. And whatever you do bad, it will be in front of you. You do a lot of good, walhamdulillah. As I mentioned to other masjid who helping the poor and need in Egypt, and I think about my brothers in Syria and Yemen. You give the money for them in Egypt to eat, they are good. But when you give it to them in Yemen, because people said, I don't know who to I give the money to. You give to the hand of Allah first before the abd. You don't know and you don't care who you give the money. If they ask, give, and that's it. It reached the hand of Allah first. Because when it reached the Yemen, you don't know the person has a piece of bread in his hand. Before he put it in his mouth, what is coming to kill him? He cannot even eat it. So you have no good deed? You have it. Who gave it to you? Allah. Because your money reached the hand of Allah first. يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا وَمَا عَمِلَتْ مِنْ سُوءٍ تَوَدُّ لَوْ أَنَّ بَيْنَهُ أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا. Will be between them and him a long distance. You don't need to see it. يَوَدُّ لَوْ أَنَّ بَيْنَهُ بَيْنَهَا أَمَدًا بَعِيدًا وَيُحَذِّرُكُمُ اللَّهُ نَفْسَ. Allah is warning you, my dear brothers and sisters. Then he said, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will forgive all your sins. Remember, Allah is mercy and kind. قُلْ أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Follow and obey Allah and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. If you ignore that, Allah don't like the disbelievers. But we are among the believers. We need to reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the good deeds. Look at Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda, how he's believing that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet. And he said to him, as-Siddiq, he confirmed whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says is confirmed, it's true. Who can believe Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the trip, from the Isra and Mi'raj? The first one, when he come back and he start ask his wife, they said, don't talk. But when they meet Sayyidina Abu Bakr, say, Aqalaha Muhammad, if Muhammad said it, that's true. It happened. Then he returned back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, it happened. He said, yes. He said, Sadaqt, Ya Rasulullah. Sadaqt. And when he needed the money and help, who's coming first? He's running. Abu Bakr Siddiq, Sayyidina Umar, when he comes with his money, say, Ya Rasulullah, it's right here. He says, Sabaqaka Abu Bakr. Abu Bakr was ahead of you. Look at Sayyidina Uthman. When he put his money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Those are the people who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know what is the price of the Jannah. So the month of Ramadan is the beginning, my dear brothers and sisters. But the month of Sha'ban is very important for all of us. Come to the middle of Sha'ban, the night of the 15th. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to the sama' al-dunya and he look at the heart of his ibad, the heart of the believers, and he forgive them all the sins, except the disbelievers wal-mutashahinan. The disbelievers, we know, al-mutashahinan, the two brothers who's not talking to each other, who has a problem with each other, they're not talking to each other, he's not talking for their family, no matter who's wrong, who's right. Allah don't look at those people, hearts. But their heart is not connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't say we did a mistake. Say, no, he's wrong, I don't care. But Allah, mercy and kind, Ra'uf and Rahim, what about you? And the one that created you, he's the one who forgive. But he cannot do anything between you guys. Even the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I forgive, subhanah, but you together, you have to forgive each others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will offer something better and better until they forgive each others. But why are we waiting for that? Why we end our years not talking to each others? Why we end our year while our deeds reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ignore each others? And we feel bad when someone not come to you and say salamu alaikum and you don't answer, because I don't like this brother, I don't like this imam, I don't like this sheikh, I don't like that. And you have it in every masjid, wal'iyadu billah, you have it. People fighting for a position, but in the grave there's no position, you have nothing. يَوْمَ تَجِدُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَا عَمْلَتْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ مُحْضَرًا. What you did good in the dunya, that's what you will have in your grave. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of us to be among the people who give and not to think. Give to the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the human being. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, your heart is very important. Remember, قُلْ إِن تُخْفُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ أَوْ تُبْدُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ. Our Allah will knows everything. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لِي لَكُمْ وَسَائِرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Inshallah, try to come forward to make room to your brother, inshallah. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's telling us, من لم يهتم بأمر المؤمنين فهو ليس منا. If you don't care about your Muslim brothers, then you're not among the believers. Where they are, it's not our business. Because now the whole earth, they have Muslims. Muslims everywhere. By the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Ibrahim alayhi salam, mu'azzin fi nas, just to call, don't worry about it. And among the generation of Ibrahim, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supported this ummah by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he reached the Jannah in the Isra and Mi'raj, he saw how the Kawthar, the place of the water, the one he's going to give it to the believers when they come to cross the Jannah from the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let all of us among the people who get sip of water from the hand of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He saw a lot in the Jannah, my dear brothers and sisters. So combine your good deeds by your salah. Your salah is very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَالزَّكَاةَ. Salah and zakah coming together, my dear brothers and sisters. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in the Jannah, he just saw a beautiful house from gold, and the lady, she's making wudu in front of this house. He said, that's the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he asked, he said, no, this is the house of Umar. ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu warda. How that come? Umar has his house. He say, Ya Umar, when I saw that, Ya Umar, I just turned my face because I know you are so jealous. He say, jealous from you, Ya Rasulullah. I cannot, Ya Rasulullah. But look, the good deeds in the dunya, Allah built the house for you in the Jannah. In his dream, he saw the steps of Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah. And he said to Bilal, how come you are ahead of me in the Jannah? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I never do any wudu unless I do to offer turaqah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I offer turaqah to Rabbil Alameen. And he has a house in the Jannah. He steps in the Jannah before any of us. You have it, my dear brothers and sisters. When you go do the good deeds, you will see it in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the day of judgment, you're going to see your deeds. If it's not fit the scales, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of your intention, your heart, your action, He's going to put La ilaha illallah, and that's everything will be in front of you to enter the Jannah, to be among the people of Ashab al-Maymana. But we have to understand, Allah is testing us in this dunya, my dear brothers and sisters. Allah is testing us by our deed. When He gives something good to us, what we are saying. And when He gives something bad, what we are saying. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, remember that. كَلَّا بَلَّا تُكْرِمُونَ الْيَتِيمِ وَلَا تَحَاضُّونَ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ وَتَأْكُلُونَ التُّرَاثَ أَكْلًا لَمَّا وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. You just love the money so much, you ignore the poor and need an orphan. And how are you going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How you meet Him and He's testing you. But it's secret in the dunya. You do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your heart is walking toward that because you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you. And you do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will give you a jannah. We need the jannah. We need to enter the Jannah. This is our goal, my dear brothers and sisters. You could prepare for the month of Ramadan. This is nothing wrong with that, because we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we learn from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. We learn it. But we need to finish our year first. Care and worry about what we have now. And the best thing you have to do in these days, my dear brothers and sisters, the dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. And we have to come to the Salah from now, preparing ourselves for Ramadan, and we ask for forgiveness at the same time from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try to join the Jama'ah as much as you can. Try to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for you. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, idha nudiya lissalati min yawm al-jum'ah, fas'ahu ila dhikri Allah. He's calling you, He's waiting for you. Imagine your boss, He gave him an appointment to meet him. You cannot sleep the whole night. And you look what you will dress, and you look at the mirror, you put the perfume, you need to look nice, handsome, because you're going to meet a human being like you. But you forget the order in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Creator, He can do all of that. Now He's asking you to come. He want to see you. He want to remember where you're at. He knows everything subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Sayyidina Ayyub, he knows that Allah gave him the disease, but he's still not blaming Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he understands who is Allah. Allah khalaqa kulla shay. He created everything. He knows what's in the earth, what's in the sky. He knows what's inside you. As Luqman said to his son, إِن تَكُمْ إِسْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُمْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِي بِهَا اللَّهِ. Every small thing inside mountain, inside the rock, inside everything in the earth, in the sky, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it. If we believe in that, we'll be among the believers. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, clear your heart with your brother and your family before anything. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He didn't need the people to come to the salah and is not talking to each other, or ignore their family, or beat up their parents. And we heard it a lot in these days. As the man, he's taking care of the older house, and the man who is in time of death, and this is true. And they say, what do you need? He say, I need to talk to my son. He called the son. The wife picked up the phone. She said, he's at work right now. Can you ask him to call the house? And when he called, he said, what happened? He says, too late, brother. Your father passed away. So what do you need from me, man? Just bury them and I will come and give you the money. That's how we are. Oh, believers. Oh, Muslims. That's how we are. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا فَلَا تَقُل لَّهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُل لَّهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. This is the result in the end. When you grow as a man, you ignore your parents. You put them in the older house and you don't care about them. The money is not everything. Allah will take the money from you one day if you think about it this way. وَخْفِدْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الذُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَقُلْ رَبِّ رَحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِ صَغِيرًا. Oh Allah, forgive them as let me grow like that as a man. The heart with your parents come first, then your family relative, and then your friend, and among the believers. Take the hand of your brother to the masajid. Tell them this is an important time in the year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he want to look about our deeds. So my dear brother and sister Islam, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these days, accept our good deeds and just switch our bad deeds to good deeds. We ask him al-rahma al-maghfura. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم أمواتنا وأموات المسلمين. اللهم فك كرب المكروبين. اللهم فك كرب المكروبين. اللهم فك كرب المكرومين. اللهم يا ربنا يا رحمن يا رحيم اغفر لنا الذنوب وكفر عنا السيئات. اللهم ارزقنا جناتك جنات النعيم. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النار يا كريم. اللهم لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك أستر عيوبنا أستر عيوبنا أستر عيوبنا وعيوب أهلينا وأمهاتنا وأخواتنا يا كريم. اللهم لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.